Hello students, welcome to Knowledge Academy. Today in this important session of English literature, I shall explain about the concept of the sonnet, its origin, its types and rhyme patterns, the Italian or Petrarchan sonnets, apart from these characteristics of Miltonic sonnet. I would like to let you know that in the end of this video, I have also included some specific multiple choice questions for exam purpose. It will be beneficial for you for making preparation of TGT PGT of English Literature, UGC NET, JRF, etc. Apart from this, this is also the important topic of BA English Literature. Hence, in every point of view, this topic is essential or important. But first of all, I would like to say that please like, subscribe, share and motivate channel for new updates. It will be beneficial for you for the sake of knowledge. And you are most welcome for your comments also for teaching learning situations. Now let us know what is the specific origin of the sonnet. Students, as we know, the origin of the term sonnet is derived from the Italian sonetto, which means little sound. The name does remind or this reminds us that in olden days it was composed to be sung in accompaniment with the lute or mandolin. Its origin is uncertain. Some scholars believe that it is first originated from Provence or Sicily in Italy. Some other scholars believe that its origin can be traced back to the Greek epigram. William Sharp in this context says or holds this view that it was sung by Sicilian peasants. That fleeting bar of verbal melody, which in its narrow compass of two lines presents one fact of nature and one metaphorical allusion based theoron. However, this should be remembered, the earliest sonnets of definitely recognizable form were written by the great Italian poets Dante 1265 to 1321 and Petrarch 1304 to 1374. The first English sonnets appeared to Tottel's Miscellany of Songs and Sonnets, a collection of lyrics and sonnets were sonnets written by various known and unknown poets of the 16th century. Two well-known poets who contributed their sonnets in or who gave their specific contribution to their sonnets to miscellany were Sir Thomas Wyatt and apart from this Henry Howard, Earl of Surrey. Thereafter, the sonnets in slightly varied form were written by Shakespeare, Sidney, Spenser, Milton, Wordsworth and Raphaelite poets of English literature. Yes, of course, this point should be remembered. The sonnets in slightly varied forms were written by Shakespeare, Sidney, Spenser, Milton, Wordsworth and pre-Raphaelite poets in English literature. Now let us know what its type and rhyme patterns. So considering in the range of subject matter, if we talk about its type and rhyme patterns, there are two principal types of sonnets according to their rhyme scheme. The number of lines in sonnet of any type is always 14. Yes, it should be remembered. The number of rhyme of any type of sonnet is always 14. There are iambic pentameter lines linked by an intricate rhyme scheme. The two principal types of sonnets are Italian or Petrarchan sonnets. So if we talk about the Italian or Petrarchan sonnets, these sonnets are named after the great Italian poet Petrarch. The Petrarchan sonnet consists of two main parts. The first eight lines form the octave, having the rhyme scheme AB, BA, AB, BA, etc. The last six lines from sestet, which may have one of the following rhyme schemes. So sestet rhyme schemes are CDE, CDE or CDC, CDC or CDC, DEE, etc. Thus we see that the lines in the octave and the sestet are separately interwoven. We also see that octave may be divided into two stanzas of four lines, each called the quatrains, and the sestet into two stanzas of three lines each called the tercets, etc. We can say that three lines are called tercets. Now let us know what is the characteristic of Miltonic sonnets. The Petrarchan sonnets, or if we talk about the Miltonic sonnets or the characteristics of Miltonic sonnet, the Petrarchan sonnets are called Miltonic sonnets in English because Milton wrote his sonnets according to the Petrarchan rhyme scheme. As we know, Milton wrote only 24 sonnets in all, but they are so superb, both in thought and as well as artistic finish, that the Milton is recognized as the greatest sonneteer to English after Shakespeare. Milton is known as greatest sonneteer after Shakespeare. I think the concept of sonnet has been cleared before you. Now let us know about some important sonnet series for competitive exams also. Sir Philip Sidney wrote Astrophil and Stella, addressed to his beloved, 1598. Or we can say that Astrophil and Stella has been written by Sir Philip Sidney in 1598. Spencer wrote Amorati or Amoretti, addressed to his bride, 1595. Shakespeare wrote sonnets, addressed to Mr. W.H. and Dark Lady, 1609. Henry Constable wrote Diana, 1592. Samuel Daniel wrote the sonnet Delia in 1592. And Sir Thomas Laws wrote Phyllis in 1593. The next sonnet, Mikhail Dreton, written or wrote Ideas Mirror in 1594. Now let us talk about multiple choice questions. So each question is followed by four alternative answers. Alternative answers, we have to select right answer. First question is, how many lines are there in Petrarchan sonnets? So of course, right answer is 14. Right answer is 14. Moving to next question, what are the first eight lines of Petrarchan sonnet called? So first eight lines of Petrarchan sonnet called is octave. Moving to next answer, what are the last six lines of Petrarchan sonnet called? So its right answer is sestet. Last six lines are called sestet. Moving to next question, how many sonnets in all were written by Milton? So there are 24 sonnets. Its right answer is 24. How many sonnets in all were written by Shakespeare? So its right answer is 154. Moving to next question, which is about Milton. The last six lines of Miltonic sonnets are divided into two groups of three lines each. What is the group of three lines called? We should know what is the group of three lines called. So it's called tercet. Next question, how many sonnets were written by Shakespeare? So its right answer is 154. Next question about Milton. Milton, thou shouldest be living at this hour. This is the opening line of the sonnet. Who has written this sonnet? So it has been written by Wordsworth. So the right answer is Wordsworth. Moving to next question, who wrote the sonnet? Who wrote the sonnet series entitled Amoretti? So right answer is Spencer. Moving to next question, Sir Philip Sidney wrote a sonnet series addressed to his beloved. What is that series titled? So the right answer is Astrophil and Stella. The next question, the first collection of songs and sonnet is called Totale's Miscellany. Who was the Totale? So the right answer is, it's the name of the publisher. That's all for today. Please take care of yourself. Thank you. I think your concept about the sonnet is clear. Apart from this, this was the description about some important sonnet series and multiple choice questions also. Thank you.